Tales from Europe. The Soupstone, from Belgium. One day a soldier was walking home from the wars and came to a village. The wind was cold, the sky was gray, and the soldier was hungry. He stopped at a house on the edge of the village and asked for something to eat. "We have nothing for ourselves," the people said, so the soldier went on. He stopped at the next house and asked for something to eat. "We have nothing ourselves," the people said. "Have you a big pot?" the soldier said. Yes, they had a big iron pot. "Have you got water?" he asked. Yes, they had plenty of water. "Fill the pot with water and put it on the fire," the soldier said, "for I have a soup stone with me." "A soup stone?" they said. "What's that?" "Oh, it's a stone that makes soup," the soldier replied, and they all gathered round to see this wonder. The woman of the house filled the big pot with water and hung it over the fire. The soldier took a stone from this pocket. It took like any stone a man might pick up on the road, and tossed it into the pot. "Now let it boil," he said. So they all sat down to wait for the pot to boil. Could you spare a bit of salt for it?" the soldier asked. "Oh, of course," the woman said, and she pulled out the salt box. The soldier took a fistful of salt and threw it in, for it was a big pot. Then they all sat back to wait. "You know, a few carrots would taste good in it," the soldier said longingly. "Oh, we have a few carrots," the woman said, and she pulled them out from under a bench where the soldier had been eyeing them. So they threw in the carrots. And while the carrots boiled, the soldier told them stories of adventures. "A few potatoes would be good, wouldn't they?" the soldier said. "They'd thicken the soup a bit." "We have a few potatoes," said the oldest girl. "I'll get them." So they put the potatoes in the pot and waited for the soup to boil. "You know, an onion does give a good flavor," the soldier said. "Run next door and ask the neighbor for an onion," the farmer told his small son. The child ran out of the house and came back with three onions. So they put the onions in. While they were waiting, they were cracking jokes and telling tales. "And I haven't tasted cabbage since I left my mother's house so many years ago," the soldier was saying. "Run out in the garden and pull a cabbage," said the mother. And a small girl ran out and came back with a cabbage, and they put that in. "You know, it won't be long now," the soldier said. "Just a little longer," the woman said, stirring the pot with a long ladle. At that moment, the oldest son came in. He had been hunting and brought home two rabbits. "Just what we need for the finishing touch," said the soldier, and it was only a matter of minutes before the rabbits were cut up and thrown into the pot. "Ah," said the hungry hunter, "the smell of a fine soup." "The traveler has brought a soup stone," the farmer said to his son, "and he is making soup with it in the pot." At last, the soup was ready, and it was good. There was enough for all, the soldier and the farmer and his wife, the oldest girl and the oldest son, the little girl and the little son. "It is a wonderful soup," the farmer said. "It is a wonderful stone," the wife said. "It is," said the soldier, "and it will make soup forever if you follow the formula we use today." So they finished the soup, and when the soldier said goodbye, he gave the woman the stone to pay back the kindness. She protested politely. "It's nothing," the soldier said, and went on his way without the stone. Luckily, he found another just before he came to the next village.